To Doughty, one timer long with a save, and he steers the puck over the glass with 19 seconds to go in the first penalty.
And you know, Ryan Smith right there in the doorstep, Sammy Salo trying to tie him up, but Smith is so good at screening and going to the blue paint. The key is the faceoff. Canucks need to win it.
Kessler does. Salo checked. Doughty holds the puck in. Want to reiterate, they're trying to score quickly, get within two, and then stay on the power play. Maybe make it a one-goal game. Kopitar to the side. Johnson with the blast, blocked by Burrows. Brown gets the loose puck. Centers it back. Kopitar shoots. Missed the net. Puck comes to the near side. First penalty's over. BX is out of the box. Doughty curling to the middle. To Kopitar, one-timer. Long with a save. Burrows has broken his stick, trying to defend without it. Bieksa ties up his man in the corner. Burrows crashes into the pile, just trying to free up the puck. Kings keep possession. Here's Johnson to the blue line to Kopitar. Burrows defending without his stick still. Kopitar dishes off to the side. Now takes a return pass to the blue line. Kopitar to Johnson. Cross to Doughty. Loses the puck. Burrows gloves it down the ice. Minute to go on the power play. 90 seconds left in the second period. Canucks leading 4-1. Here's Brown on the left wing, centering, intercepted by Bernier. He feeds up to Mason Raymond at center, who takes his time and now chips the puck into the LA zone. Raymond throws a hit, some up ice pressure. Now the Kings wheel the puck back to center. Kopitar leading the way, wrists it in. Hard around to the near side. Good job there by Edler to free it up, and it's slammed down the ice by the Canucks.
Pretty impressive stuff right now. Who said the Canucks can't kill a penalty? They killed a two-man advantage, 28 seconds of that. Now they just have another 20 seconds to go here.
Modine with a low shot, right pad save Luongo. Edler trying to clear the puck, had it deflect off the glass and out. So the faceoff will be in the Canucks zone. There's 16 seconds to go on the power play and 49 seconds left in the second period.
Well, this is really huge for the LA Kings. Down 4-1. Given a real golden opportunity to peck away at the Canucks lead, especially with the two-man advantage. But the Canucks so far have done the job, killing it off. They have another 16 seconds to go.
Just the three shots for LA now. And Canucks get the puck off the draw. It's chipped out down the ice by Edler.
That should do it.
What a bullet to dodge here in this series. Everybody knows what the story's been. 2 seconds to go on the Ehrhoff penalty. Now he comes back on the ice as the Kings chip the puck in. Fans recognize what's occurred here, too. Here come the Canucks, four of them to center. Daniel Sedin leading the way. They're 4-on-3. Drop pass. Henrik cuts to the middle. Henrik tried to return the pass to Daniel. Couldn't get it through. Hanzus collects the puck deep in his own zone. Fires it blindly ahead, but he'll get it past Edler and out to center. 12 seconds to go in the second period as Edler wrists the puck in deep. Hanzus gets it. Drops off for Jones. And the fans will start to come to their feet now as the puck is sent out of play with 1.6 seconds left in the period. Their ovation will be curtailed a little bit, but they've liked what they've seen here in the second as the Canucks have taken firm control of game five.
Shots 9-5 in favor of the Canucks in that second period. Overall, 21 shots for the Canucks, 13 for the Kings.
They'll drop the puck one last time to the left of Erzberg. Thought they might throw a right-hand shot in and try to put it right on goal. Instead, Henrik will try to draw it to Samuelson for a one-timer. Near impossible, given the time, 1.6. Kopitar to take the faceoff for LA, and he wins it. That'll do it. Sedin, Daniel, and Samuelson with his sixth of the series. Two goals in the second period, and the Canucks lead by three. Second period done here at GM Place. It's game number five in a series tied at two. Canucks 4, the Kings 1. You're listening to King of Floors Playoff Hockey.
Jim Houston to tell you about the Mitsubishi Right to Play Challenge. With every vehicle sold, Mitsubishi Motors will donate $100 to Right to Play, the organization using sport and play to help kids in disadvantaged countries around the world. And with $1,000 off select 2010 Lancers in addition...